Our Bibles, our notebooks, ready. Have we got our Bibles ready?
Yes.
Thank you. As we always do, let us try to recapture what we learned last week. What was the title of last week, our Bible studies? Okay. Stop, yes, sir.
It was trust in the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. What did we say about that? What did we say about that? Okay, sister.
Judas betrayed Jesus with a kiss, and don't trust in mankind. So yeah. He let you down.
Yeah. Our sister is talking about how Judas Iscariot, whom Jesus Christ trusted and therefore shortlisted him as one of his disciples, betrayed him. Thank you.
Yeah, and then you explained to us that we should be very careful whoever we are going to work with, whether our husbands, our wife, our friends, everywhere that we go. We need to be very careful because not everyone that we can trust, because we can get somebody who can betray us as well as a Christian.
Amen. Amen. It means we are learning our Bible very well. Yeah, because I always talk about last week, everybody is able to. Next time I'll be talking about what we learned in last 3 weeks.
Oh, yeah.
And we'll see how things go. Okay, thank you for your marvelous answers. We are in the month of February, and I've got some series for this month, and I've entitled that Strengthen Your Faith. Strengthening your faith in God. Strengthening your faith in God. We'll be looking at this in series. So today, the title will be Learning to Forgive. Learning to Forgive. Are we okay?
Yes.
All right. So, learning to forgive under the main team, which is strengthening your faith in Christ. I want us to share something from Mark chapter 11, verse 25 and 26. Mark chapter 11, verse 25 and 26. Are we there? Thank you.
When you are praying and you remember that you are angry with another person about something, forgive that person. Forgive them so that your Father in heaven will also forgive your sins.
Thank you. I take it again. 25. And when you stand praying, forgive if ye have aught against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses. 26. But if ye do not forgive, neither your Father, which is in heaven, will forgive you your trespasses. Amen.
Amen.
Our subtitle is Learn to Forgive. Forgiveness is something that has been very difficult for Christians. Forgiveness. Something that has been very difficult for Christians. We come to church always. We pray to God always. But when it comes to forgiveness, it becomes very difficult in our life. It is not surprising to see members of the same church, members of the same ministry, having a grudge, but they all sit in the church and they all pray together. Forgiveness. You are in a church, you have a grudge with your fellow member. You all stand in the same church and you pray there is darkness. You want to pray and then remove the darkness. Meanwhile, you are the darkness yourself. You are the darkness yourself. Do you see what happened? And you stand here and you pray, you want the light to show. You want the light to shine in your life. And the light will never be shown. And you begin to question yourself. Why? Why? Because you have not learned to forgive the other. As the Bible is saying in the Mark chapter 11 verse 25. That, and when ye stand praying, forgive if ye have ought against any, that your Father also which is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses. You have not forgiven your fellow church member. You have not forgiven your fellow neighbor. You have not forgiven your fellow friend at work. You have not forgiven somebody you have a grudge with. But you come to the church and you tell Almighty God, forgive me my sins. Hallelujah. Amen. God should forgive you your sins. But you don't want to forgive. Your friend sinned or committed an offense against you for just once. Can you count the number of times you have sinned against God? Can you?
No.
You can't. But you pray to God to forgive you your sins. But a friend who has only sinned against you for once, you cannot forgive. You see how it is?
Yeah.
You want more, but you don't want to give less. You want more. From your childhood to this stage, how many times have you sinned against God?
Mm-hmm.
And every day, God, I have sinned against you. Every day, God, I have sinned against you. Forgive me my sins. But the person who insulted you just a day is your number one enemy. I don't want to see this person again in my life. I will never talk to this person anymore in my life. And the person is just behind you. And you are praying, God, forgive me my sins. But you don't want to forgive that person. Can that work?
No.
So we should learn to forgive. Because if we don't forgive, our Lord Almighty will not also forgive us our sins. Let's continue to look at something from Acts chapter 7, verse 60. We get a lot of continues, we have to be a little bit faster. Acts 7, 60. Acts chapter 7, verse 60. That's the last verse. Yeah.
He fell on his knees and shouted, Lord, don't blame them for this sin. These were his last words before he died.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This was his last word before he died. Who was that?
Stephen.
A talking about Stephen. What was happening to him?
When they were stoning him to death.
When they were stoning him. What is so cruel? What can you equate to this kind of atrocity? Somebody who is killing you. And he stood there and said, Lord, forgive them. Can you do that as a Christian? You call yourself a Christian, you come to church every day. Can you do that? These were the people who were stoning him to death. They were killing him, they were taking his life. The person you don't want to talk to again, the person you were saying you will never, you don't want to even look at his eyes, was he killing you? This is the person who was being killed, but he was bold enough to pray for them, that Lord, forgive them. For they know not what they are doing. This person whom you are talking about, that you are not going to talk to anymore, he was not taking your life. Maybe a small thing he said about you. But you are so furious to the level that you don't want to even set eye on that person again. But you come to the church and you pray that God should forgive you yours. Amen.
Amen.
Let us learn to forgive. If we don't do that, we can't strengthen our faith in Christ. We can't. Let's look at something from Luke chapter 6, verse 28.
Ask God to bless the people who ask for bad things to happen to you. Pray for the people who are mean to you.
Amen.
Amen.
Bless them that curse you. And pray for them which despitefully use you. What is the Bible saying? We should do what?
Bless
those that curse you. And pray for them. How many times have you prayed for your enemy? How many times have you prayed for the neighbor that you fought with because there was even a disagreement between your child and the neighbor's child? It was not even involving you yourself directly. It was your child that was fighting the neighbor's child, and you, the elderly person, the parents, get involved. You get involved. And the following day, you see that the children, they are on the field, they are in the garden praying together. And you, the parents, have made your mind. You are not going to talk to each other again. But the case that brought about the whole issue or the confrontation, you see them praying together.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
A story, it's not a story, it's a real thing. Two ladies, old ladies, and their grandchildren are fighting. And the other one came to fight for hers. And then the other woman said, why two children are fighting together instead for you to stand in gap and then make them peace? You old woman, you are fighting for yours, so me too. I will come and stand behind my wife. So both of them, the old ladies, started to fight. So it wasn't a long time, then the one passed away. So when she passed away, she stood, she found herself in the throne of God. And then everything on her is perfect. The white garment, everything was perfect. But one dot was the garment, and then the gate was locked. It wasn't open for her. So the woman said, why? And the angel said, look, you have a spot in your garment. That's why this one? Then they showed the screen to her, and this woman saw that the day that she fought with that the other woman concerning the children's fight, they said, please forgive me one more chance. And then the angel said, okay, I'll consider you now. Go and tell your people not to do this. And the woman, when they were, she was lying on bed, people were crying, go around to see, to give him her the last respect. And then this woman woke up. Say, hey, please, so please come, everybody come and listen to what I brought to you, these people. And then this woman narrated the story to all the people that they were there. So it's true, if this woman forgive or leave, let it go, that maybe, oh, you, this woman, you don't know what you're talking about. Please. And then taking her one and went home. It won't be a problem for her. Because she avenged. That is what. So if somebody do wrong to you and you too avenge, it means you are going to hell. Hallelujah. So what the topic that has come now, you should be very careful and study it carefully and keep it in our mind. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
What do you say to your mom? God bless you. Thank mom so much. That is the word. That is the word. We are our own enemy. We prevent God from blessing us. Yes. We prevent God from blessing us. Because what God wants us to do, we don't want to do that. What God wants us to do, we don't want to do that. But we want God to bless us. God said we should forgive one another. We don't want to forgive, but we want God to forgive us. How possible would that be? Let's look at something from Luke 11, verse 4.
And forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And don't let us yield to temptation. Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
And forgive us our sins, as we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Jesus Christ was teaching them how to pray. Now, when you kneel down to pray, you pray to the Almighty God to forgive you your sins as you forgive those who trespass against you. Do you forgive them? Do you? I remember those days at school, this was like a routine. We say this every morning. When we go for the parade, we recite this every morning. But when we go home, we continue to do the same thing. We don't change. And Christians do this. Christians do this. We pray every time. But Jesus Christ is saying that you pray to God to forgive you your sins, ask you. Because you see that one depends on the other. Because you are going to pray to God to forgive you your sins as you forgive those who trespass against you. And therefore, it means without you, if you look at the context very well, without you forgiving the person who trespass against you, God will not forgive yours. Because one depends on the other. Jesus is telling them, showing them how to pray. And he's saying that when you are praying, you pray that God forgive us our sins as we, which means you are forgiving your friend or whosoever has offended you first.
Yes.
But we don't do that. And we sit in the church and we pray, God, we need this, God, we need that. We make a lot of resolutions.
We are wasting time.
We make a lot of resolutions.
We are wasting time.
Yes. We are making resolutions. The neighbor is sitting by you. You don't talk to the person. The neighbor is sitting by you. You have a grudge with the person. And you say, Lord, forgive me my sins as I forgive those who trespass against us. Meanwhile, the person is there. You don't want to see the person's name. Even the church, you don't want the church and the person to sit by you. You see how things go. And you stay in the church for years. Oh, I've never seen God blessing on me. And then you go home. You go, and I'm not going to church again. Who is at fault? You.
Why God is not answering?
Why?
Prayer.
Why?
Why?
Why in 2010 why? I made resolution. Why? 11 I made resolution. 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. But none of them had ever come to pass. Forgetting that you are a co-worker, you're always having problem with him. The co-worker mistakenly spoke to you negatively. And you harbor that in your heart. You harbor that. Sometimes you go, you greet a person, but even the way you greet a person, it's not coming from your heart. It's not coming from your heart. So we see how we prevent God from blessing us. If we want to strengthen our faith in God, we have to learn as a Christian, we have to learn to forgive.
Amen.
We have seen what happened to Stephen, somebody who is being stoned to death, but was able to forgive, pray to God that God forgive them. This person you are not talking to, this person you don't want to see, he has not even killed you. Maybe what he even did indirectly has even helped you one way or the other. But you don't know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's look at something from Matthew 6, verse 14 and 15.
But if you refuse to forgive others, your father will not forgive your sins.
So you see how many,
hallelujah,
how many verses are talking about this forgiveness, which is very, very, very important. Look at how many we have seen today. They are all talking about forgiveness of sins. I take it again. Matthew 6, verse 14 to 15. For if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. I've just said, one of them depend on the other. Your own is first. For you to forgive the person who offends, you have to forgive the person who has offended you first. If you don't do that, and you spend hours, millions of days to pray, God will not forgive you yours. Because you are supposed to do your part first. And you don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. You don't want to give, but you want to receive. Yeah, that's how it is. You don't want to give, but you want to receive. Let's look at something from Ephesians chapter 4, verse.
How can you receive?
Yeah, that's
your
it.
Your hands is like
this. Yeah, you can't even grab it.
How can you receive?
Yeah, because.
And before you receive, we have to open your hands.
The 4, verse 31 and 32.
Don't be bitter or angry. Don't lose your temper. Never shout angrily or say things to hurt others. Never do anything evil. Be kind and loving to each other. Forgive each other just as God forgave you through Christ.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you with all malice. And be ye kind one to another, tender hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake have forgiven you. Look at the 31. Let all bitterness and wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you. How many times you do that? How many times do you insult people at work? How many times? Be frank with yourself. When you are assigned to do something, oh, this man, why am I the only person to do that work? And you use all kind of negative words. You use all kind of negative words at that particular person just because he has asked you to do that job. You get angry, you use the word. And yet you also pray. I'm not saying you are a human being. You are bound to offend others. But be bold enough to open your mouth to say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It's just simple word. Simple sentence. I'm sorry. Sometimes you might have a case. You might have a case. What you are saying, you might be right. But for God's sake, please say, I'm sorry.
Amen.
Because if that person is not ready to say it, and you also keep that anger in you, you are preventing yourself from God's blessing. So, do you want to have that because of what the person is doing to you? You want to prevent God from blessing you? Just, I'm sorry. And then you continue with life. That you are sorry can bring that person, even if that person doesn't know God, can bring the person to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
But you don't want to do that. The person has offended you and you are angry. And the person that you are doing that to, he knows every Sunday you are in the church, every Saturday night you are there praying. So what is that person going to say to you? If at work you take your Bible, you tell you, oh, don't mind that person. He's not a Christian. He's just pretending. And he's right. Because he knows that you are different from him. And what happened between the two of you? You could have done something to reconcile. But you are harboring that as a Christian, which you are not supposed to do. See, the person will doubt your Christianity, and it's right, he's doubting it. But if you are able to reconcile with the person, oh, I'm sorry if I offended you with the word I used, the person will just have a second thought. Oh, truly. The moment you say you are sorry, the person will also know that he did something wrong. Oh, I'm also sorry for what I did.
And you put shame to
the reconcile. The person, you will get a time, you will get a chance to speak the word of God to the person. No, brother, I said I'm sorry because my Bible, my Jesus Christ says that if I offend you or if anybody offends me, I should reconcile with the person. Will you join me to go to church on Sunday? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do you do that? You don't. But that is an opportunity for you to bring the person. I hope you are going to do that.
Amen.
No, yes. Only yes.
Amen.
I hope we are going to do that.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, we have time. Don't think about time. Today is Sunday. Let's look at something from Matthew chapter 18. Verse 21 and 22.
Matthew 18, chapter 18, verse 21 to 22. Then Peter came to him and asked, Lord, how often should I forgive someone who sins against me? 7 times? 22. No, not 7 times. Jesus replied, but 70 times 7. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. How many times?
70 times.
Peter was only talking about what? 7 times?
No.
But what was the answer from Jesus Christ?
70 times 7.
How many is that?
490.
490. 365, 1/4 days, yeah. And Jesus Christ is...
What does it mean then?
It depends on whether it's a... So, let's back to our business. We just calculated, we said 490 times, according to what Jesus Christ said. And we are saying that we have 365 1/4 days in a year. And I don't think any person within a year will wrong you every day, every time, till that 360. Even that will not be even up to the 490. But Jesus Christ forgive the person for 490 times. But you have made your mind that somebody offended you for just one time. One time. One time. And you have made your mind never to talk to the person again.
3 days ago, sorry.
Again. And you would never, never, never get God's blessing. Yeah. Yeah, that's how it is. That's what you're saying.
Yes.
Because, okay, let's give it to some mommy.
Amen. My problem is, we Christians, this forgiveness scripture that our brother, God is leading our brother today to, especially now, for what he is teaching us now, he's teaching us, we that we are in this house, so we are the only people that we can hear. So even outside we hear it, it's going to be later when we send
the message
out there. But my problem is, we that we listen every day, do we even respect God's word at all? We don't respect the word of God at all. Why? Because anything that we are doing, we do it because I am myself.